I'd love if you could perhaps walk us through your process as an artist. So maybe take us through from the moment you set eyes on someone that you think could be an interesting subject and just what draws you to a person to begin with. And from that first moment, let's go all the way to the moment where you have this finished, gorgeous portrait in hand where you feel like you've truly captured the essence of this human being and it's ready to be shared with the world.
Right. Yeah. First of all, I think everybody has this feeling when you're walking down the street or wherever you are, there's people that just kind of stand out and make you do a double take. And that's kind of my first sign, I guess, that I recognize, like there's something there.
Mm.
And the type of people that I'm really drawn to are, as you can see in the book, is people that have a lot of character and story visible on their face. Mm. Before you even learn the story, you know there's a story.
Mm.
So, yeah, the first thing I would do is try not to be creepy. approach the person in a way that is very human, you know, just make some small talk, talk about the weather, whatever, and then kind of gradually get to the photography part.
Mm.
And a lot of times, you know, I'll just say something like, you know, I'm a photographer. I love to photograph people that have a lot of character. And I couldn't help but notice that you have something about you that is just amazing. I would love it if I could photograph you. Wow. And I make sure that I point out that, you know, that I'm not going to charge them and I tell them what's in it for them. I'm going to actually share the images with them and all that stuff. And I like to carry my phone with me with my whole portfolio on my phone so I can show them, you know, kind of what to expect.
That's smart.
Yeah. So, and I don't think I've ever actually photographed somebody on the spot. It's always kind of, I see them, I approach them, we have the conversation, and then I kind of leave the ball in their court usually to follow up and get back to me. I really dislike pressuring people. I feel like if I pressure someone, I'm not starting out the right way, you know?
Yeah, right. Totally.
I like to have an element of trust right from the beginning.
And sorry, one quick question there. Do most people say yes, Wayne, when you position it like that?
Yeah, surprisingly. I've had a couple that have said no, and that can really hurt sometimes, especially when you see a lot of potential there.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, most have said yes.
Wow, that's awesome. Yeah, so they said yes, and then maybe you get a date on the calendar, and how does it kind of pan out from there?
So, yeah, I guess the next thing is I like to have a conversation with them and learn more about them. And I always try to have an element of story in my portraits. So the more I learn about them, the better. And once I am on location, like we usually choose a location that means something to them or has some kind of a relevance, anything that can add to the story will include. One example, Geraldine Robertson, who has sadly passed on now, she was a survivor of residential schools.
Yeah.
And one problem we had is I wanted to photograph her actually in front of the residential school, which still stands. It's turned into a cultural center now.
Mm.
And they would not allow me to do it. So I had to find a way around that. So what I did was I actually had Geraldine hold on to a book that had images of both schools actually that she attended. And so, you know, that had some relevance and actually made the connection to the location. So it's just a picture of her hands. She was in her 80s. So there's a lot of character in her hands and then the book itself. So there's a story right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, usually I can walk into a space and kind of visualize, you know, where I would put my lights, how I would bring the mood. And then a lot of it has to do with what is in the space that adds to the story. Now, that being said, there's one shot of Leona where it was more of a like spur of the moment thing. It's a close up of her and she has tears in her eyes. And it's actually she's telling me in that moment that she was so focused on her own safety and her own well-being as a kid in an abusive household that she never even thought of the fact that her brother might be going through the same kind of stuff. Mm. And so in that moment, she's telling me how guilty she feels that she didn't help him, and she's in tears. And that's when I got that shot. So I intentionally kind of set it up, but I watch for the moments within that setup.